It's been a turbulent 2 weeks in the world of sports politics, but for the next few minutes, we're going to turn the focus back to sport. So, coming up on Sports United this week. We gallop over to Aachen for the Rolex Grand Prix. We see double in a Taekwondo family affair. And it's a knockout with the great Teddy Riner. The best show jumpers in the world gathered in Germany to compete at the prestigious Rolex Grand Prix in Aachen. Along with Spruce Meadows and Geneva, Aachen makes up the Grand Slam of the equestrian circuit, and over the weekend, it was the venue for an historic victory. Well, Britain's Scott Brash became the first rider in history to win two of the Rolex Grand Slam competitions in succession. After his triumph in Geneva in December, Brash was one of seven riders to make it through to the final jump-off in Aachen. Last to go, the 29-year-old riding Hello Sanctus jumped clear and set a winning time of 48.04 seconds. If he wins September's Spruce Meadows Major, he will be the first ever winner of the Grand Slam and bag a €1 million bonus for his achievement. Daniel Dusser, riding Corne d'Amour, threw down the gauntlet earlier in the jump-off. The German piled the pressure on when he also jumped clear and clocked 48.37 seconds, but it wasn't fast enough as he had to settle for second place. Rounding off the Aachen podium in third was Simon Deleste with Ryan Desayet, while Ludger Bierbaum was fourth. The third and final leg of the Rolex Grand Slam in near Calgary begins on September the 9th. The 10th edition of the annual Archery World Cup stopped off in Antalya, Turkey for the second leg of this year's four-part preliminary series. The compound event turned out to be one for first-time winners. Let's see who enjoyed their maiden individual victories. Andrea Marcos fired herself and Spain to a first-ever victory on the Archery World Cup in her first appearance on the elite circuit. 26-year-old Marcos, ranked 33 in the world, beat Russian Maria Vinogradova in a tight affair. Nothing could separate the pair throughout, and after both hit a 10 in the shoot-off, Marcos was declared the winner after her arrow landed marginally closer to the centre. There was also a maiden winner in the men's compound. Kim Jong Ho of South Korea celebrated his first World Cup title when he beat Mr. Perfect, Mike Schlosser of the Netherlands. Schlosser was the pre-match favourite, but Kim was in stunning form and eventually squeezed out the victory, beating his opponent by 1 point. The Olympic shooting range in Munich played host to the sixth stop of the ISSF World Cup. It saw a record-breaking number of athletes compete across 10 Olympic rifle and pistol events, and also saw a German contingent thrill the home crowd with a golden performance.
Andre Link claimed his first World Cup gold in the men's 50-metre rifle three positions. He took the lead after the opening kneeling position, controlled the field through the prone, and then secured gold and an Olympic spot with a strong standing position performance. The German fans were celebrating another gold when three-time Olympian and 2010 world champion Barbara Inglieder won the women's 50-metre rifle three position. Germany enjoyed three gold medals on home turf. Christian Reitz won a thrilling men's 25-metre rapid-fire pistol final. With a score of 32 hits, he outshot USA's two-time Olympian Keith Sanderson, who picked up the silver with 26 hits.
On Spotlight this week, we take a look at a rare family affair from the world of Taekwondo. Ana and Lucija Zaninović are identical twins from Croatia. As well as their looks, it's also difficult to separate the pair in terms of success on the tatami.
When she wins, it's like I win. I didn't win, but I win like her. Because she wins, I win.
Ana is a former world and European champion in the under 53 bantamweight class, while Lucija is a three-time European champion and 2012 Olympic bronze medalist in the flyweight under 49 kilo division.
We came on the training for the first time at the same time, but she didn't like Taekwondo, and she came back for one year later.
When Ana fights, it's the worst thing. We can't watch each other. The coach doesn't let us because it's too emotional.
Tony Thomas is the twins' long-term head coach and knows the characters of his charges all too well.
Ana is always leader, and the Lucija is followed. Ana and Ana always go hard, and Lucija go wherever Ana goes.
Despite high kicking at the highest level of their sport for nearly a decade, their feet remain firmly on the ground.
I train, I do my best. Of course, I want to win a medal, but if I don't win, it's all the game. I love Taekwondo, I enjoy doing Taekwondo.
We are healthy, we have each other, and that's the most important.
Yeah.
It's judo's equivalent to boxing's knockout. Yes, it's an ippon. Once you're down, you're out. To help explain some of the techniques involved in delivering the ultimate blow, we've gone right to the top. Seven-time world, four-time European and Olympic champion, Teddy Riner.
Judo,
in a few words, is uke-tore, which is two opponents that confront each other. If you are intelligent enough, it's knowing how to use the force of the other to throw them down, to put them on their back. When you've done that, it's ippon, and you've won the combat. The four ways to score an ippon is one, strangulation. Two, immobilization. Three, the arm block. And then the one you all know is to throw your opponent on their back for ippon. An uchimata is simple. You need to establish a strong grip called a kumikata. Then you take your adversary where you want, when you want, in order to start the uchimata. You need to use your hip well, then pass underneath your opponent's center of gravity, kick your leg out with force, still holding the strong grip, and then normally it all follows, and they fall. Well, that's almost all we have time for. We sign off this week with images from the IAU 5th Trail World Championships in Annecy, France. Congratulations to French pair Sylvain Cour and Nathalie Mauclair on their victories. From all of us here at Sports United, thanks for watching and see you next week. Goodbye.